Okay, so here we are. We're at the NEC in Birmingham for Vaper Expo 2016. And I'm sat here at the moment with vaping advocate extraordinaire, Dimitris Avagrafiotis.
You're too kind.
I'm stuttering is what it is. What have you made of it so far?
Fantastic event, great organization, huge, much bigger than it was last year, sure.
It's ginormous.
A little bit of the same old as we see in the United States as well, too, as far as the booth setup. There's a lot of U.S. manufacturers here,
yeah.
So we don't feel like we're too far away. But overall, fantastic. And they spent a lot of time on advocacy, too, which I'm very proud, something that a lot of the events lately have been missing.
I've got to say, I was really, really chuffed to see, I don't know how many you thought there was, about 500, 600
people? At least, yeah.
And they were all there chanting for vaping and listening to the advocacy. Dimmy was on stage giving it his all.
Yeah, I think it was extremely important when you come to events like this. Sometimes we get lost in the freebies and the big show and the marketing that's going on. But if you saw, the organizers here gave us the stage for about an hour. Me and Dave and Matt from Suck My Mod was up there. And we basically asked the crowd to give us their questions. How do they feel? Their fears. Because a lot of people are confused.
Yeah.
A lot of people are worried that they're not going to be able to vape. So it was really refreshing to see that every single question, and we got a lot of them. I think we got 20, 25 questions from the crowd. Every one of them was extremely important and very, very well versed. And you know, hopefully the answers that we gave them, and mostly with the direction of the TBD, hopefully the answers that we gave them were fulfilling, and they can take that back and educate other vapors that possibly couldn't have been here today.
It was absolutely amazing, and it's all been filmed. So you'll see that played in, we think, on Monday night show with Marco and Matt, the whole thing, the full bit from on stage, the full advocacy session. I'm falling over my words, we were so loud.
Yeah, it was loud and people were fired up because people are passionate about vaping. And that's one thing that the government and the regulators and the public health can't take away from us. So it was really nice, really just to see them all fired up. And I think that this is something that they can take back to their hometowns and their local vape shops and their local groups and can say, you know, I was there when we were talking about this. Don't be afraid. Vaping is not going anywhere. Yeah, it might change a little bit the way that we're vaping, but compared to the United States, man, I'm thinking about moving here to the UK, I'll tell you that much.
Hey, we'll happily have you.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know, your food's a little bit, you know, you're going to have to work on that.
You mean there's not enough of it?
Not enough of it, true that too. But one thing that I wanted to ask you, Dave, is this misinformation that's floating around, what more can we do as advocates, especially, you know, you guys that are here, and even us from across the pond, what more can we do to get the word out and give accurate information?
Well, I think we've got to use a pyramid effect. At the moment, the advocacy networks that are online doing what we're doing now have a number of viewers. We need those viewers to put the word out and get more viewers. I mean, quite honestly, Vapor Trails TV, the Vapors Network UK, and all of the other networks need to be seeing 20 and 30,000 live viewers hanging on there every word so that they know what's going on, so they're properly informed. That's what we've got to see. We've got to get it out there. People have got to use their voices. We've got to do it loud, we've got to do it long, and we've got to do it with as many voices as we can muster.
And it shouldn't depend on freebies just to be able to listen to. I mean, you shouldn't be expected to get something free to listen to what advocates have to say. And I think that a lot of the marketing that we've done with this product the last 3-4 years has kind of misdirected. But now, literally, the shit has hit the fan. It's here.
Yep.
It's here in the UK, it's here in the EU, it's here in the US. So if you don't act now, when it's the most critical intersection of this path that we're taking with our vaping journey, it's going to be gone.
That's exactly right. The time to act was years ago, but we've got to act now. If we want to save vaping worldwide, we've got to act now.
One more thing that I want to tell before I go, and thanks for having me, is not only are the vapors misunderstood or they have misinformation, a lot of the industry has as well, too. And yesterday we were part of a TBD compliance conference. We were just trying to educate and let the manufacturers from China and U.S. liquid manufacturers understand what the TBD is. And even, you see, even within the people that are doing the TBD compliance, they're not fully aware of the ever-changing TBD regulations.
I would say not even aware.
Yes. So one more recommendation that I want you to expand a little bit on is, how does the industry get accurate information? Don't believe the first Tom, Dick, and Harry that comes and sells you and says, oh, give me all your money and I'll get you TPD compliant. How do we get the business, the industry side of it as well, to be aware of what the regulations are going to be?
Well, as far as the UK is concerned, there are industry trade bodies, IBVTA, ISETA, and ECBA, that are all tuned in to the MHRA and have all of the details that are coming out of there. They need, everybody, every vendor needs to get tuned into one of those three or all of those three bodies and make sure they're bang up to date with the information coming out of the MHRA and the Department of Health. You can also get the information direct from the MHRA simply by subscribing. They will, and it costs nothing, they will send you emails with all of the information you need to know and links to all of the regulation as it stands. From there, you can very easily choose who you're going to work with, because you'll know whether they know as much as you, because that guy last night didn't.
Yes, it is. It's funny, I was walking by a booth earlier that had these 100 ml ketchup bottles and for liquid, and I asked him, I said, what are you doing about the TPD? He said, oh, we're TPD compliant. I was like, what? What are you talking about? I said, your bottles are 100 ml ketchup bottles, don't even have childproof caps on them. You're not TPD compliant. I was like, oh, yeah, well, our attorneys have figured out. Well, listen, if you're a consumer, vote with your wallet. Do not support these fly-by-night companies that are just dumping this product into the EU market. You're never going to see them here next year. They never have invested in advocacy. They never invested in your right to purchase their product. So please be aware of that. Vote with your wallet.
Do you know what? I love your passion. I really love your passion. And it was a pleasure to share a stage with you.
It was really an honor to me as well, too. Thanks for everything.
Thanks for the last 4 years, mate.
Thank you. Looking forward to four more.
Oh, and the rest. 44 more. That was Dimitris Agrafiotis, the vaping Greek, all the way from America via Greece. Next up, what we're going to be doing this afternoon is bringing vendors onto the stand that have got new product to look at. So who's going to be up first? We've got Rock Slime coming up. So, right, do you want to just kind of pan on and we'll bring them on? Rock Slime! You're due up. Are you going to talk to them, Marco? You'll let me, will you? Okay, come on over. Whoever's doing the talking, take a seat. You do the talking. Rock Slime. Doing really well. I'm Dave.
Simon.
Hiya, Simon. So what have you got that's new? Tell us about it.
We've got two new flavours. Got Raider, Fruit Loop cereal, ice cream. Literally one of the best vapes I've had so far. Nice, clean, crisp flavour. Uh-huh. Nice, fruity and creamy as well. And obviously that ice cream piled in there. Pretty nice. Also, we have the Vicious V there. Basically, that's like a fruit kind of drink. Looking at like your Vimto kind of style, like cheeky bit of blackcurrant stuff out in there. Okay. Real nice, juicy all day vape.
Which one have you got in there?
I have the Vicious V.
Okay, can I have a try?
I don't know, mate. I suppose I'll let you have one.
What?
Oh, go on then.
That's the mint, is it? Right, so here we go, dripping. Right.
There you go, mate.
Bottom button, I take it.
Yeah, press her hard.
Pardon? Right, let's try it. Try it left-handed.
Is it locked?
It's a long, long time. There we go. No? Ah, oh, bollocks. I think I can safely say producers. What I'm getting out of that is a large quantity of forest fruits. There's definitely blackberry and blueberries in there, with a little bit of bilberry, and there's just a touch of sparkle behind it. Is that what it's intended to be?
Well, that'd be giving away our secret then, wouldn't it? If I told you what it was. But
say yes.
Might be something to do with that, maybe. Maybe. You never know.
And the other one, I'm not sure I can say, it's called Muckafucker.
It is.
Muckafucker Raider.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm gonna do this the way I would normally test a juice, and this is called the moose knuckle technique. For those of you that don't know, Moose Knuckle is the male version of Camel Toe. You put a little bit on your knuckle and then you lick... No, stop it, David. There's a definite element of an ice cream in there. I've got... There's raspberries and bilberries coming through with banana. That's really rather nice. Oh, yeah. I've got some bad news for you. They're mine.
Well, I don't know about that. I'll
Well, you've got a choice. You either take those two bottles or those two girls back to your stand.
Keep them, take them, have them all.
There you go. So that's Rockslang. They are here at the NEC. You doing special offers over the weekend?
Oh, of course we are, of course we are.
Tell.
For 30ml bottles for 30 quid.
For 30ml bottles for 30 quid. Non-TPD compliant. Fill your boots. Thank you very much.
It's nice to meet you, buddy.
And you. Yes, what did you say about the TPD? Do bear in mind, ladies and gentlemen, this is live. So there you go, that was Rockslime. Thank you very much for visiting us here live on vapertrails.tv. We'll come and have a look at the stand later on, and I'm sure a whole load of vapers will be as well.
Have a good day then.
Thank you very much.
Cheers very much.
Cheers, man. Take care. Right. Now, who have we got lying? Mr. Kitson, come in and bring your camera.
Bring your camera. It's not my camera. Do what we like to this camera. It's Matt's
camera, is it? Yeah. So now then, Mr. Kidson, you've been wandering around this show shooting lots and lots of video. What have you seen that's excited you?
I've seen quite a lot, actually. I think the main thing that jumps out when you come in here is the sheer scale of it. It's absolutely enormous, isn't it? Is there anybody missing?
Missing.
To start from there, think of a vaping brand. Is it missing from here? It's not, is it?
I can't think of a UK one that's missing at all, no.
It's everybody's here, and they only just fit in this massive, massive arena.
Yes. I mean, to give you some idea of how big this thing is, if you can imagine Wembley and then multiply it by 10 pitch sizes at the very least.
At least. Yeah. Yeah. Wembley and Twickenham together.
Both together, yes. Yeah. In fact, to coin the phrase from round here, it's bloody massive, it's ginormous, it's great big.
Huge.
Is what it is. Right, so who have we got lined up next to come on? Aha, here's Hell's Kitchen. Dev, do you want to talk to Hell's Kitchen? I'll take that camera.
Go on then, well, I'll talk to Hell's Kitchen.
Give me the camera.
You have to press record.
Okey-dokey.
Come on in.
Thank you very much, sir.
I'm shorter than everybody else. I don't know whether you've noticed. So, Hell's Kitchen.
That's me, boss.
Tell me about Hell's Kitchen.
Well, I started homebrewing about 12 months ago.
Right.
And decided that I was going to give up my job as a freelance graphic designer.
Right.
And
so I bet your bottles are pretty then, are they?
They are, not bad.
Yeah, okay.
You can see for yourself.
I'll put my glasses up and then I'll see for myself. Very nice. Very minimalist sort of design, that.
Yes.
Yeah, we like that. We like that, black and white.
Thank you very much. So yeah, I gave my job as a designer.
Needs a bit of red in it.
There is a bit of red in some of the branding as it happens.
There you go. Yeah. Told you, I like this guy.
So I gave up my job as a full-time graphic designer for myself.
Right.
And ploughed what very little dough I had left into producing this.
Right.
And I'm fully TPD compliant as we move along, and I'm actually now being produced and manufactured by Earl Science.
Fully TPD compliant, that's as a bit of a brave statement.
As we go along. As we go along.
I'll let you off with that one. We're not here to be harsh, are we?
Mm.
So, where are you based?
We're based in West Bromwich.
Oh, so just down the road?
Just down the road.
West Bromwich doesn't actually exist though, does it?
Not really.
It's Smethwick, isn't it? That's where you're from, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, okay, so you brought along two juices, I see.
That's right.
Named Damnation.
Damnation and
Purgatory. I think I might like the sound of those.
The flavour profiles are there, that's the Purgatory and that's Damnation.
Okay, right. So one's apple and one's cinnamon waffle.
Cinnamon waffle and butterscotch.
Cinnamon waffle, yeah, I tried that yesterday. The cinnamon on it is very, very subtle. A lot of cinnamon flavours that you get are very overpowering.
Hold that microphone.
There you go, sir.
There you go. Going for Damnation. I don't do Apple.
No?
We might drag Dave back in to do the Apple in a minute.
You might be surprised.
I'd be surprised if I like it. It's Apple. Cloud. 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 Oh, I like that.
Thank you very much, sir.
That's very nice.
Thank you very much.
That's Damnation.
Yep.
Damnation. I'm not going to do Purgatory because it'll mess up my wick.
Good.
Yeah. No, Matt, you're not doing anything.
Come on, be the guinea pig.
I've already delegated holding the mic.
All right. Okay.
Try that juice, mate.
What are you doing?
You need something to drip it up.
I do. You got something to drip it up?
Not mine, mate.
I've got no dripping with me.
What you got in that?
Another brand.
Good self-promotion, I like it. So,
I'll tell you what, I'll do it the old-fashioned way, shall I?
Do it the old-fashioned way. Why didn't I think of that?
There's no answer.
I don't do old-fashioned.
There you go. Put up my nose. I don't want to taste the. I don't want to taste the mic.
Tell the camera, tell the camera.
I'm getting lots of creaminess out of it.
That's right. Well, the description says, a freshly baked apple pie with vanilla pod ice cream. That'll be the creaminess.
Aye.
Topped with a splash of marshmallow and finished with a drizzle of caramel sauce.
Caramel, yes. Apple, I'm not getting so much.
Hold the mic. Hold the mic.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Thank you.
It's apple. You can't taste the apple.
I wasn't getting the apple.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, if apple's something you don't particularly like,
you notice
that first, don't you?
Oh,
yeah. Way
worse. Do you not like apple then?
Yeah. So you can have that one.
Oh, thank you.
That's mine now, okay?
You're more than welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Lovely to
Cheers.
See you.
Have a great expo, guys.
Cheers. Yeah, you too.
Okay, now what are we doing? Who's next?
Who's next? Shall we talk to these guys? I'm going to give you both the chairs as well because. Are we still in frame there, Marco?
Yeah. All right. Oh, yeah. God.
Let's get around here. I'll get the. Yeah, I'll move over.
Right, I've got a feeling that most people who are watching this will recognise these guys. Because this is Tim.
Hi.
And this is Bella. And you did a video, didn't you? Who wants to tell me about the video?
Tim. Video is literally me vaping in a blanket, listening to Snoop Dogg.
Right.
So, yeah, I was literally in a moment of pure vape. It was brilliant. It was perfect. It was a perfect moment. And Bella managed to capture the whole thing.
Right.
And it was the randomest video.
God, describe what happens in this video.
Describe what happens. Literally, you hear this knocking on the door, Tim, what are you doing? And then literally, it's me kind of silhouetted in the blanket.
Right.
Kind of bopping my head along. And then all of a sudden, comes out me in the blanket, listening to Snoop Dogg. You're slowly kind of hearing it. And then all of a sudden, it kind of zooms in, and I'm just doing this. And boom, that's the video right there. And you just hear Snoop Dogg.
So basically, you walked in on him.
Yeah.
I was going to go in there. I basically, like, a lot of people sit there and say, like, a lot of comments said it's fake and rehearsed. And honestly, I couldn't have predicted that.
You interrupted what sounds like an intimate moment.
Yeah, I film a lot of things, like, when I surprise people. And there's a lot of videos, like, along with that video, my videos, of me surprising with Christmas presents, birthday presents, stuff like that, like T-shirts and stuff. You've seen those videos. And like, I like to see his reaction. I like to keep that. That's exactly what I went in there to do. But it got completely interrupted, and that's literally the real story there. Like, it's completely not fake.
I've got to ask, whose idea was it then to put it? It was on Facebook that it first went viral,
Tim.
Was it?
I had the control over it, but it took about a day of convincing.
Literally, what ended up happening was, I said, Bella, I literally looked at her straight in the eyes, and I just went, put this on. Watch it blow up. And she was looking at me like, this is the most stupidest video. It doesn't make any sense. I'm like, just do it. And then literally, she put on like, guys, share this to embarrass Tim. I'm not embarrassed over it.
And how many views did it get in the end?
It ended up getting 4.3 million hits.
4.3 million hits.
On Facebook.
How many?
4.3. That was just on Facebook, and then you put it on YouTube. Is that right?
Yeah, that's now it got like 40k in a day, a night or something like that.
14k in a day on YouTube.
40, not 14.
40, 40, yeah. 40.
But it's been shared everywhere else.
It's been picked up by like Storyful as well. They're going to try and do like a whole article, and they're going crazy with it. I actually saw myself, like, I was googling myself. I was like, okay, let's google myself. Googled myself, literally. I was on like an FM radio in America, and it was like an old rock channel, and I was like, oh, no way, it's me, I'm there. And like Bella's like looking at me like, what are you doing? You're just pointing at the screen saying it's me there, because she's seen the video like a million times anyway.
I hate hearing
she's
you
the
know.
One who's picking it.
And you've done follow-on videos now.
We're planning. Like, we can't think of like one that's going to...
Watch out.
I heard said it's very hard to plan a viral video,
that's
isn't
the thing.
It?
Like, it's hard to plan it, but, you know what I mean?
It's going to be one of those moments where I look at Bella and I'm going to say, record now.
So you're just waiting for that moment to happen, basically.
I don't know about it. I'm going to be surprised.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And so why are you at Vaper Expo this year?
We're working currently right now with UFA.
Right.
We literally just came in for a day. They kind of said, hey, we like Bella's look, let's go ahead and do something. And all of a sudden they were like, hey, I was like, hey, my name's Tim. And then they were like, oh, you the trickster. I was like, me the trickster? Of course, I can do tricks, I can blow O's. So then I can't even do it. So I don't know why they're hiring
me. It's
too
windy in
it. I'm just that guy who runs around like giving people bags. Please come to our store. 50% off, come on.
50% off, was that?
Yeah, 50% off.
UFO.
Yeah, a UFO. There's some really good stuff. We got like...
Go to booth 106.
We got like this synthetic nicotine that they've made called Coastline. That's literally my favorite right now. They're trying to get go through like the TBT, through the like loopholes, because it's not actually the nicotine that comes from the actual tobacco leaves.
Right.
Instead, it's synthetically made.
Right, so, and they think that'll get them out of it, do they?
They think.
It won't. I have my doubts, but I applaud the ingenuity.
The camera guy's literally like, no, not today.
This synthetic nicotine is something of interest to me. I mean, they've always said it's too expensive to make, haven't they? It wouldn't be cost effective. Well, not for me, obviously.
You know, seriously.
For people who buy juice, I mean.
You can drip a six.
And don't steal it off people who do.
So yeah, definitely. But we're trying to also work with Gallery Vapes as well.
Right.
We're currently trying to get a nice affiliation going because we actually live stream.
Right.
I live stream with Bella. You'll see me. I'm just a cloud of smoke literally coming in and out.
Was that
camera.
On YouTube, is that?
No, that's on Twitch, actually.
Twitch, okay. Yeah.
Twitch streamers, I do usually gaming.
Yeah.
So then I always like to Bella.
And what's the URL on Twitch? What's your ID?
It's
twitch.tv/Bella Jinx.
And if you guys want to go onto the other website, which is even better, it's literally www.gamingforgood.net/s/Bella Jinx, sorry. And basically
they're going to be really glad they can pause and rewind that.
Yeah, that is they're probably I just see guys just nodding at the screen like, what is this guy doing?
10 quid gets you a dot live with something.
Really?
It really does.
But yeah, like over there you can end up like donating to charity at the same time. You can actually help us stream as well.
Yeah,
so that's
okay.
Also good for Save the Children. Cool. I'm a big charity event guys, so, you know,
okay, we'll throw a final question to you then.
Okay.
What's the best thing that's happened today, this event, what have you enjoyed most?
I'm about to enter into Miss Vapor UK.
Miss Vapor
UK. I got
UK.
Invited to, and I'm absolutely...
Invited or forced? Go on, you can be honest with
me. I really want to do it. I'm just really scared. But, like, they invited me to do it, so that I guess that's the best thing, because...
That sounds like the kind of event that VTTV need to be covering, actually.
Yeah. Well, yeah. It's certainly going to be interesting.
Get the cameras
we're here to report, aren't we?
Are you entering?
We should get you a
I might.
Dress.
They have these
I don't know what's in it.
All the models to wear.
It's not going to work on it.
Does my bum look big in this?
Yeah.
No, your bum looks big in everything.
Guys, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thanks
a lot.
Thank you so much, dude.
Cheers, guys. That's it.
I'm going to go around.
Don't kill yourselves on the way out.
We got Luke now.
We got. Hey, Lucas. There's Lucas. Would you like to talk to Lucas?
Honest,
so it's me hogging the mic. Come in, Lucas. Come in. I'll hand you over.
There you are. Check a few, sir.
Ah, there he is. This is what we like.
Gifts. Right here?
Yeah, you sit there.
Cool.
All right, so we got Lucas from Hometown Hero all the way over from yeah, all right. We'll get to that.
How you guys doing?
We're doing fine. All the way from Austin, Texas, aren't you?
Yes, sir. All the way from Texas. About a 14-hour flight, but it was worth it. It was fun. Beautiful show. It's probably one of the best shows we've been to yet. And amazing crowd, great group of people. Everybody's been extremely nice, extremely receptive. So very grateful to be here.
Yeah. Is your first time over here?
Yes, it is. I've been to Berlin, but this is my first time in England.
Okay. And you reckon you'll come again?
What's that?
Do you reckon you'll come again?
Oh, yeah. We'll be back. We'll be back. This is an excellent, excellent show. Absolutely love it.
Okay, so tell us about your juice. Tell us about the ethos behind your juice.
So we started this company because we were fed up with what was available in the market. And it's not that what's in the market is bad, it's just that we felt like it was overpriced at the time. So we decided to do a 50 mil at the same price everybody was doing 30 mils for.
Uh-huh.
Unfortunately, we pissed everybody off, but we've gained an amazing group of customers that absolutely love us to death. So we do a very high quality premium line only using the best ingredients, and it's a 50 milliliter bottle, and we sell it for the same price everybody else sells their 30s. And one of the only ways we can do that is we're our own distributors essentially. So when a store in the UK buys from us, they buy from us directly. There's no distributors in the UK, there's no distributors in the US either. So any retail store that works with us buys from us directly.
Right.
So it ends up working out quite well.
Tell us about the artwork on this, because I've heard it's actually proper graffiti.
Yeah, so like on the Witch Doctor bottle, let me find the Witch Doctor one. So on Witch Doctor, this piece is actually about 30 feet tall. You can see the no parking sign on the side of the label.
Uh-huh.
And the artists are all from Texas. They're amazing guys. And all these pieces of work were done on brick walls and different areas. Nothing illegal. It was all sponsored artwork.
Right.
But they did them all because they're amazing artists, and we give back 1% of the profits to the artists as well. So a lot of these pieces in real life are, you know, upwards of like 30 feet tall and 30 feet wide. They're huge. So we shrink them down. We take these pictures and we shrink them down to make them fit the bottle and look beautiful. But most people don't realize how big these pieces actually are. Gigantic. And the cool thing is, these pieces no longer exist.
Really?
So these pictures that are of these pieces are some of the very few pictures that exist of these. And they live on in our bottles. So the artists get to sort of have this piece that continues to live on. Whereas in reality, if you go back to where this piece was painted, it's no longer there.
There we go. Buy these shoes, get works of art you can keep and frame.
We get contacted by artists all the time to do label art for us, which is great, and highly encourage any artists out there, reach out to us. We're always looking for new artists. Right now, everybody's out of Texas, but we're very open to artists from all over the world.
Okay. So what flavors we got then?
We'll start with Ambrosia. Ambrosia is a berry melon citrus. It's really tough to describe flavors vocally and camera.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll do the short descriptions. Highly encourage you guys to try them, you know, sort through them. You guys have your own personal favorites.
Rice Krispies.
We've got Angel Tears, which is based on a popular snow cone flavor in the U.S. Angel Tears is, in the U.S. they call it a tiger's blood. It's a strawberry coconut watermelon.
Right, okay.
Really popular flavor. And then we've got the little evil little brother, Angel's Breath, which is a frozen version of that with a slight amount of culotta.
Uh-huh.
We've got Red Dream, which you guys don't have it in the UK, but kettle corn over in the US is like a sugary popcorn.
Yeah, I know that, yeah.
With some strawberry cream. So we, for the longest time, we didn't want to do a strawberries and cream, and we had some of our stores fighting us over it. So finally we gave in and we decided to do a strawberries and cream, but we wanted to do it very, very different. So we do it with a popcorn, which is completely contrary to anything else that's out there. And it's a very different flavor, but it's very good, very light, great all day vape.
Uh-huh.
We've also got Rice Krispie Treats, which you guys love.
Rice Krispies.
So, and it's funny. So in the UK, nobody knows what a Rice Krispie treat is. They know what Rice Krispies are, but no Rice Krispie treats. So in the US, a Rice Krispie treat is the Rice Krispie cereal with heaps of marshmallows melted all over it. And then you cut it into squares and eat it like a cake.
We buy them as squares.
Rice Krispie squares.
There you go. So yeah, I'm saying treats. Nobody knows what the hell I'm talking about.
Squares,
okay. Yeah. Rice Krispie squares. I'm going to have to change the label because of you guys.
That's what you do.
And then lastly, we've got Witch Doctor, which we don't talk about much. It's sort of a limited flavor. We do it in small batches.
Uh-huh.
But it's probably the closest thing you can describe it to is a good Cuban cigar.
Really?
Sort of milk chocolate and tobacco and sort of thick and delicious. A lot of people that don't like tobaccos tend to gravitate towards this, even though they don't like tobacco vapes. Tobacco vapes tend to have a sort of odd chemical taste. And once you, we really work to get away from that and get it into sort of a more natural tobacco flavor with a cigar. And I think we succeeded. Everybody tends to love it.
Okay, so what's in that right now?
This is Angel Tears in here.
Can I have a go?
Yeah. 35 watts on a little knee box.
Okay. not particularly airy. Am I covering something up?
The wattage is probably low. Let me see what I got. Down to 35 watts. Let me turn it up a little bit. You gotta be careful with these little leaky bastards.
Alright. This is why I don't have one.
The battery might be low too. We've been pounding all day on it.
There we go.
So we avoid using sucralose in almost all of our flavors. Only one of the flavors has a small amount of sucralose. I'm not a huge fan of sucralose. A lot of companies tend to overdo it with the sucralose and make it overly sweet. I prefer ethyl maltol as a sweetener. Yeah. I think it's a little more clean. You get a better flavor. To me, ethyl maltol just seems to come across better. Obviously, it's two totally different sweeteners, but we tend to gravitate towards the ethyl maltol. You can get a little bit more of a better all-day vape on an ethyl maltol. Sucralose tends to gunk up coils, and it doesn't sort of last as long on the palate. It sort of overpowers it. So we try and stick with ethyl maltol whenever possible.
That's lovely.
And
angel tears, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. In terms of ingredients, we really pride ourselves on trying to use the absolute best ingredients available. Most people don't know this. There's multiple types of vegetable glycerin available.
Yes.
Multiple. There's also, you know, obviously multiple types of nicotine available. There is only one type of PG. Technically, it's all synthetic, you know, pharmaceutical grade PG. So there's not really a lot of variance there, but on the flavorings, on the VG, and on the nicotine, there is a lot of variance.
Right.
So we tend to pride ourselves on sort of making money not an issue and only getting the best quality that we can, and then providing that same value to the consumers. And like I said, we're selling 50 mils for the same price or lower than what everybody else is selling 30 mils for. Uh-huh. So everybody else tends to hate our guts, but, you know, if you aren't pissing somebody off, you aren't doing it right.
Well, I like it.
Thank you.
Finally then, where can we get this stuff from?
We've got about 10 stores in Ireland right now, and we're going to be picked up at about 20 stores in the UK. We're having more conversations than I can count, so probably within the next week, we'll have new stores on the website. It's just hometownherovapor.com, and you can see literally on the homepage, it's got a listing of every store we're in the world. There's about 300 stores on there. It's in alphabetical order. So Ireland is after Indiana and Illinois. It's right. Mixed in there with all the states and all the countries and everything. It's just craziness. If you want a little bit more concise, you can click on the store locator on the top, and it'll take you to the map and show you all the stores. But we like just throwing all the stores out there and letting everybody see where we're at, what's going on. And we just love what we're doing. This isn't a hobby to us. This isn't a game. This is a serious business to us.
Good. Yeah.
And, you know, especially with all the regulation and everything going on, we're trying to, you know, provide the best value for the consumers. Obviously, it might change a little bit in the future with taxes and some of the other stuff they're trying to push on this nonsense. But, you know, we're going to try and maintain, you know, our goal as a company is to provide the best product that we possibly can at the best price. So regardless of what happens, we're going to try and stick to that.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much.
Cheers. Thanks, guys. Appreciate
it. Cheers. Dave.
Yes, it's me. It's me again.
Oh.
Hello.
Am I staying or am I leaving?
No. I've got a woman coming.
Oh. I see how it is. I see how it is.
I'm sorry you know all that, Lucas. I've got loads of time for you. You're far too pretty for me to sit beside.
Love you guys. Take care.
Cheers, man. And coming now, live, is the one and only. Go and get some juice, Matt. It's B. Berenice. Come on. Ms. Evans, one of my heroes. Heroines.
Thank you.
You're not allowed to say that.
I've had a cuddle off B, yeah.
Have a cuddle off B.
Have a cuddle off B.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Cuddles off B. So, right, Mrs. Thursday gone, people were voting for you, because I should tell everybody, this is Bea Berenice, who was stood on behalf of Vapers in Power, VIP, in Wales, in which constituency?
It was the Welsh, wait, no, it wasn't, it was the Cardiff Central region, sorry.
It's been that heavy a time, has it?
A bit of a chest infection as well.
Oh no, we can't have you having a bad chest. That's never been said of B. You can't say B's got a bad chest. That would just be wrong.
Better now.
Good. So, come on, tell us about it. What happened? What have you been doing?
Right, well, obviously, we had to draft the leaflets. We had to get them all printed, sorted, proofread, sorted by weight as well.
Uh-huh.
There were 195,000 leaflets.
Woo!
I know. 2 days, elastic banding them all, having them in the boxes the same way. Being labelled, being shipped out to the post office at 7 o'clock in the morning. Managed to do that. Then obviously trying to talk to everybody and anybody that we could that would listen. There was a record turnout for the voting, which made a real difference. But I think, to be honest, it's because an awful lot of people are really fed up with Labour, especially in the Welsh Assembly government. The good news is Lee Wools stood for Cardiff West. He ended up with 97 votes. I stood, obviously, for the region and ended up with 470. But it's not about those numbers, because we weren't really campaigning for Vapors in Power. If we'd have won...
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
I can just imagine... Yeah. The B as an AM having to go to Parliament. That would have suited you down to the ground, though.
Well, I would have suited it, darling, but the manifesto really wouldn't have, because it was just about vaping.
That's fine. I don't have a problem with that.
No education then, no schools, no...
No, I'm just a vaper. Right, that's all I'm bothered about, just vaping. I'm a single-issue voter.
It would have suited you, but it obviously we were trying to get voters not to vote for Labour.
Yes.
The final result was that Mark Drakeford, or Labour, ended up with 29 votes, so he's not sitting as comfortably as he could.
Right.
So
that's his margin, 29?
He's got 29 now, 29 seats.
Right.
As Labour. So we're feeling better for it. A lot of people did vote for other parties, which was fine, because we weren't really campaigning for just Vapors in Power anyway. So we'll just have to see what happens sooner rather than later now.
Yes. Well, on behalf of Vapors in Wales, and indeed all over the UK, I want to say a great big thank you to you and VIP for doing this, because I reckon you've rocketed vaping up there into the news. I've seen a lot of mention of it in various different papers. And as advocacy goes, that's putting your neck on the line, because you never just know with these things, do you? You could have been elected and you'd have loved that, wouldn't you?
Well, some of the emails that we had through, quite a few of them were pro-vaping. Some of them wanted us to go and die, basically, which was another side of it, but you've got to have the rough with the smooth, haven't you?
Well, yes, and I should imagine Mark Drakeford's had a fair few emails wishing exactly the same probably. On him. Yes, probably. So where next? What's next with VIP?
Well, I don't know. We're gathering back together again now. I'm assuming we're taking sort of the end of this week. We're making it just that little bit quieter. But we have suggested that possibly we'll set up a direct debit whereby you spend £2 a month or £4 a month, a bit like saving a panda, just to try and get some more money in, because Vapors in Power is hugely important, you know, just like NNA.
Yes.
We need the money.
Yes, yes, very much. But you look nothing like a panda.
You haven't seen me at 3 o'clock in the morning.
No, and can I just confirm for anybody watching, I definitely haven't seen B at 3 o'clock in the morning in any way, shape or form, however nice that would be. So any final words for everybody out there watching?
Well, just keep your eye on NNA, keep your eye on Vapors in Power, and just fight everything and anything you can. You know, we're stuck with the TPD. Brexit, I'm voting to leave. I'm hoping that other people will as well.
Yes, fingers crossed on that one. B, for the moment, thank you very much, my dear.
You're more than welcome.
Right, gentlemen, the rest of the team, have we got who's up? Right, we've now got Marco's going to come on. Who are you working with, Marco? Right, so here's Marco. Marco, come on. There you go. Tell everybody what you're doing.
I'm here. Oh, Dave just fallen over the television stand. Oh, dear. Joining me now, when I just take my mod out, this is Matt from Hang Seng.
How are you guys?
Hi there, Matt. Are you settled?
I'm fantastic, you?
I'm not bad. Are we okay, Dave?
Yeah.
Yeah, sweet. Dave's taking all the juice. He's a monster.
Dave Kitson.
Not Big Dave, but Little Dave. Not King Dave, but Little Dave. Anyway, there we go. So, Matt.
Mark, put us on here?
Put it on there. That's great. First of all, tell us, what have you got on your stand? I know you're kind of a new start, aren't you, really? So tell us a bit about the company.
The company itself, we've been about for about 3.5 years now. We're based in Nottinghamshire, Mansfield. You know, we used to do market stores, as most people started. Now we've got 8 shops. We've got 4 shops in Lincolnshire, 4 shops in Nottinghamshire. We sell lots of ranges, but we are here today promoting Hang Seng. Hang Seng Series 8, which is a brand new line. It's absolutely fantastic stuff.
Tell us more about the Series 8. What's special about it?
Well, it's you know, it's a professional made liquid by a professional company, so the quality is fantastic, the standards are high, the packaging's professional. You know, we're not screaming fancy pictures at you. You've got your nice professional bottle with a nice flavour inside.
Okay, and this one is fruity...
Fruity donut.
Fruity donut. Is that what you've got in there?
That's what I've got inside here.
Right, let's have a little go. Do you mind?
Yeah, no, not at all.
What's it set at? 55 watts.
Can you handle that?
Oh my God.
It's big that, you know.
That's a lot for me.
Drum roll.
I've got my Rolleau that goes up to 250, but it never goes anything above 50 really, but there you go. Yes. I'll give it a go. What's the ratio of PG to VG?
It's 70 VG, 30 PG.
Yeah,
it's fantastic quality, really.
Let's give it a go. Look at the size of that. Jeez. Matt was just telling me you can fit eight coils in here, and I said that's just far too much work for me to put eight coils in.
It's a big job. Okay. I only did it the once.
I can't even put one coil in a minute because I've got all my coiling kit with me, apart from the chuffing screwdriver. How stupid am I? Never mind, I'll have to find one from somewhere.
Coil Master's right corner.
Yes, I'll have to go and see Coil Master. Anyway, here we go, let's have a go. Now, I've got to say, that is quite fruity. I'm feeling rather fruity at the moment. It's not the heat, it's the juice, honest.
Well, the heat don't help. Does it need any more on it?
No, it's fine.
Is that fine?
I'm kind of getting a bit of donut at the end.
Well, it's more like, most donuts are like fried batter. So, you know, you have a vape, it tastes like a fried batter donut that you get from the fair. This is more of a donut, like a bread donut, like what you get from Morrison's, would you say? Somewhere like that, you know?
Yes, I would say so,
like
although...
Like a creamy donut rather than a batter. You know what I mean, don't you?
Now, see, I do like a raspberry donut, but I also quite like an apple donut. And I really like a custard donut.
I like donuts.
Yes, well, so do I. And those of you who watch VapeJars TV often, we'll know that I used to eat more donuts than I eat now because I don't eat any now. What was that, Jill?
Do they make orange donuts?
I tell you what, I do know you can get a Jaffa Cake donut from Waitrose. Cool. Yes.
I bet that's expensive.
Now, Jill has had to bring up the word orange because last year's Vape Expo at the bar, the guys were putting slices of orange in my beer.
Where it began.
And there happened to be a concert on at the same time. Yes. So listen, have you got any...
Sweet Caroline!
Have you noticed, dear viewer, have you noticed that when I was on the camera, I was all very nice and everything else. I did do a little thumbs up when Nick was on the stand because his juice is immense. But I was fairly sedate. But now when these guys come back on the stand later, they're going to get some jip. Anyway, Matt... what have you got on the stand offers wise if people haven't decided if they're coming yet, if they're going to watch this and then think, oh, we're going to go tomorrow, this being Saturday and tomorrow being Sunday, and it's 10 till 4 tomorrow, it's 10 till 6 today. So if anyone's going to come tomorrow, what have you got offers wise?
Feel free to visit us, we are handing out testers. All you got to do is pop to our stall and try a little flavour and give us a bit of a rating on it, and we'll give you some samples and send you on your way. We don't mind sending you a sample home if you've got friends at home as well. You know, we're not tight. We're here to promote our brand and do well.
You're not tight. You're definitely not from Yorkshire.
We're not tight. We're not far from Yorkshire. just that little bit far enough away to not be tight.
Yeah. I came past you on the way. Basically, anything south of Sheffield for me is too far south. But there you go. And according to Dave Dorn, anything south of Newcastle...
Anything south of Middlesbrough, no!
Can I just say, boss, that today has been so successful. Our range has been fantastic. People have been rating it through the roof. So, you know, really is worth trying, you know, coming in to try, because the feedback we've had today after customers has been immense. It really has, honestly. They're loving all the flavours. We've got 25 flavours in total.
Yeah.
So, you know, we've got something for everybody. There's mints, there's menthols, fruits and sweets and drinks. So, you know, we've even got tobaccos. We've got, like, the high VG tobaccos, which is not very popular. But, you know, some people like a tobacco, so we stock it.
I don't like tobacco. No. I don't know why. I think it's just because... when I switched, I was kind of fed up with the taste of tobacco, so I really wanted to kind of go away from that. So
fags are disgusting now, more so than ever, especially when you quit, the smell of them, you know, they're not nice. I couldn't vape a tobacco myself, but there is some people out there that like them. So
yeah, a lot of people still like the tobacco flavours, and they still obviously want to buy those.
Yeah.
So, so if you want some tobacco, you know where to go. What's your stand number, Matt? He doesn't know.
I'm not sure.
Well, we're stand 203, straight 204, so if you are considering on coming tomorrow, come and see us. Pick up a free pen. Dave Kay's just putting out more free pens. Yes.
Free pens. I'm having one of them pens.
Oh, there we go. Jill C has just told us. We've got our very own chat room here live on screen. Here we go. Dave's going to zoom around to you, Jill.
Can I have one of them or no?
There you go, Matt.
Oh, thank you very much.
You might need tightening up. There you go.
Vapor Trails TV.
Vapor Trails TV. Legends. Free pens. So, yes, they're on 126, according to Jill.
Yeah, 126.
There you go. Thank it's you. All good. Thanks a lot, Matt. We shall see you soon.
Thank you very
Cheers,
much.
Buddy.
Appreciate that. That's for you.
Thank you very much. Who have we got next, guys?
That's it, I think.
Yeah, is that it?
That's it. So, right, let's get the whole of the team in, if we can. Matt's here, Dave, Mr. Kidson. Come on, we've got to sign off. Get in front of the camera. Grab in a bit.
Dave!
Mr. Kid. Oh, look, we'll sign off without him. Right, guys, we're here at the NEC. This has been an almost live version of VaporTrails.tv from here at the NEC. Come on, Mr. Kitson, hurry up.
God, oh, dear.
I was talking to that nice gentleman over there.
Yes. So, from the four of us here, we'll try and put another show out a little bit later on. We're having a few technological difficulties. It's not working very well.
The Wi-Fi's are very scrambled.
Yeah, the Wi-Fi's are extreme. Internet chickens are buggered. Right. Or as I said on stage, they fooked.
Yes, you did.
I did.
You mentioned that word quite a few times.
Well, that's because they are.
I thought you said fuck.
Especially in the States.
Yes, absolutely right. So, ladies and...
Are you shot now?
Yes, you're in shot now, Dave. So, from all of us here at the NEC, for the moment, say bye-bye, Matt.
Bye-bye, Matt.
Say bye-bye, Marco.
Bye-bye, Marco.
Say bye-bye, Dave.
Bye-bye, Dave.
See you later. From the NEC,
Boston.
We want to be together.
Cut.
Cut.
Cut.